coming to you from Oracle Code 2018 in Chicago. I'm Bob Rubart with the Oracle Developer Community, and my guest is Ken Kousen.
Cousin.
Is it cousin?
Like
Ken Kousen. Okay.
There's no way you'd know. It doesn't look like it at all.
That I should have asked, but that's okay. So, Cousin Ken.
Yep.
What are you doing here at Oracle Code? Tell me what you're talking about.
Well, I gave the keynote, which was Tales from the Jar Side, you know, stories from the past, present, and future of Java, mostly past and present. It was pretty much my own personal relationship with Java, you know, and how when I was a career changer, that's pretty much what enabled it, and that by spending time with the Java programming language over the years, it's more or less been, if you will, the soundtrack of my career change, you know, that's my second half of my career.
Do you have a favorite Java story?
I don't know that I have a favorite. I spent a lot of time in the Groovy programming community as well.
Oh, okay.
And that they're a very friendly group, and when you work with Java, you're still Groovies on top of Java, and they work together very closely. So whenever I have to, say, work with XML or JSON or anything like that, I switch from Java to Groovy and back.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very happy to work with Java as much as I can, especially with the new functional features and stuff. And I just, my most recent book was the Modern Java Recipes book that came out last summer. It's all about the functional features in Java.
With this massive evolution of Java, in your estimation, what has remained the most constant?
I mean, with Java itself.
Yeah, with Java.
Well, the nice thing for me is the write once, run anywhere part, you know, that, and the backward compatibility. I mean, I've, in order to prepare for this talk, I had to dig into some code that I wrote 15 years ago.
Wow.
Or more, and I was amazed by the fact that I could still get it to run, even on Java 8 and 9. It
Wow.
wasn't a problem like that. So that's been very, very helpful for me. So pretty much that would probably be the biggest thing for me.
And what do you think has changed the most?
Well, the changes in Java 8 basically rewrote the language. I mean, the fundamental idioms of how you go about developing in the language, using streams and lambdas and method references, it's a completely different way of approaching programming. And it works just fine, but it's a transition for a lot of people.
How do you think people are handling that transition?
Well, my experience has been that most people in the community have moved to Java 8, but they're not necessarily using Java 8 features.
Okay.
They're using the Java 8 compiler to compile the backward compatible stuff. And that's partly what I do when I give talks and things like that, is try to help them learn the new functional aspects of it.
Mm-hmm. An ever-expanding field of programming languages, what makes Java a good choice?
Well, I like the fact that the virtual machine may even be a bigger contribution than the language itself. The fact that you can innovate on top of the virtual machine that gives you languages like Groovy, like Clojure, like Scala, like Kotlin these days, that allow these different developers to try out new things and to experiment with new features in the language, and yet still everything residing on this nice, stable, secure, ubiquitous platform. I think that's wonderful. That's the biggest contribution as far
yeah.
as I'm concerned.
And obviously JavaScript has, you know, is a tangent to that, but that's exploded.
Yeah, my condolences about that, right?
Why do you say that?
I just don't find JavaScript a fun way to code. That's all.
Really?
I deal with it if I have to, and I know that the latest changes in it have improved it considerably. But for a long time, it's just not a fun programming model. I mean, it doesn't even have a compiler, really. It's all interpreted, and
yeah.
and you've got all those browser issues and stuff. But I do like what they've done with it relatively recently. And, of course, through Noshorn now, in Java, you can actually invoke JavaScript.
Yeah, a gentleman I had interviewed not long ago had referred to JavaScript as a full citizen in programming languages now. So I thought that was an interesting take. What most excites you about the future of Java?
Well, I like the fact that it's now moving again. It was pretty stagnant for a while. You know, things didn't really change much. It was turning into what people were calling the COBOL of the 21st century, and that's no longer the case. I mean, it's clear that they are adopting new ideas, they're learning from the other language communities, and it's growing, and there's always something innovative inside it. So I'm enjoying the changes that are being brought along, and I'm very optimistic about the future.
So what advice would you give to someone who's just entering software development and they want to learn Java? What advice would you give them?
Well, the real challenge in learning Java, if you're not an object-oriented programmer, is that leap from procedural coding to object-oriented, even though when you hit Java 8, now you're talking about functional paradigms as well. So that's the hard part. Plus, there's the fact that there are so many things to learn. I mean, there's the build tool environments and the IDEs and the various open source libraries like Spring and Hibernate and things like that. So it's a challenge. But if you start with basic introductory Java information, materials, that's the foundation for everything. And that can be really nicely done. Now, there are some good intro books out there. I haven't played with too many of them recently, but the real help there is to talk to people who do code in Java, because that way it's not just a question of syntax or semantics, it's learning how to think like an object-oriented developer. That's the real key.
What book do you keep within close reach on your desk?
Oh, well, for beginners, I've always liked the Head First Java book.
Okay.
But that's for beginners. For personally, let's see, what do I spend a lot of time with? Well, right now, I'm dealing with a lot of the in-action books.
Okay.
You know, Kotlin in action, Groovy in action. I do a lot with the Spring framework as well. So I've been spending more time on those areas.
Are you working on a new book now?
Well, I finished the one, and in principle, I'm supposed to be working on something Grails related, but we'll see how that goes.
In principle?
Well, it's been delays, and I've been very slow about it, so I don't know if they're happy with me right now, because I'm taking a long time, but, you know.
Do you, how involved are you in electronic publishing? I know I've talked to other authors, and it's, you know, the time lag for print publication, especially in the tech space, is a handicap.
Well, I like the O'Reilly system a lot. That's who I've been very happy to work with, because everything's written in ASCII doctor, everything is checked into a GitHub repository, and you just click a button to generate a PDF or generate MOBI or EPUB, you know, so that you can preview things very quickly. It's a quick turnaround. Now, I know I have some friends who've looked at like self-publishing areas with LeanPub and things like that.
Yeah, yeah.
But it seems to me that cuts down on the audience by a very large amount. You know, you don't seem to get nearly the impact. So I've been very happy with the editors and the people I know at O'Reilly. So from the EPUB point of view, from the electronic point of view, they provide it. The electronic stuff is there, and it's nice when a print book eventually shows up in the mail.
Well, Ken Kousen, thank you for sharing your insight and your time. If you'd like more information, more content about Java, you can visit the Java section on developer.oracle.com. Plenty of articles and videos and podcasts covering all things Java. That's developer.oracle.com. For the Oracle developer community, I'm Bob Rubart. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.